Time now for our rants and raves, starting with you, John.
Well, I have a mega rave for, I'm going to butcher his name, I don't know how it's pronounced, Igor Bobik, I think. He's a political reporter for the Huffington Post, who produced one of the most seminal pieces of journalism covering that zombie apocalypse at the Capitol. That's Eugene Goodman, the Capitol police officer, who heroically kept this approaching mob of zombies at bay as he radioed for backup and retreated back up the steps of the Senate wing. See the zombie following him? Right now, you're going to see, he looks down the hall, he sees the doors to the Senate chamber are wide open, and he dupes the idiot into following him the other way, undoubtedly saving lives there. But Bobik, look how close he is to what's going on here.
Yeah.
Look how steadily he's holding his iPhone. The cinematography is worthy of a George Romero movie.
Yeah, it's great.
And it told a very important story here. Kudos to that guy.
Yeah. Great, agree, John. Good one. All right, Lylah.
Excuse me. So I have a rave for ProPublica for Joshua Kaplan and Joaquim Sapien, who wrote a piece this week about Black officers in the Capitol Police Force who have warned for years about racism and racist episodes. And they connect it to perhaps why white supremacists were so easily able to storm the Capitol. It's a really harrowing read that takes a deep dive into the history of the group, but it's well worth your time.
All right, Kelly.
I have a rave for the Public Radio Program Directors Association. They 20 more of them wrote a letter and sent it to the New York Times complaining about what happened with the Caliphate podcast. You'll recall that it was pulled because the main character was proven to not be truthful. And the Public Radio Association people said, that's not our issue. Our issue was the Times did not come clean about Barbero's relationship to the person who's in charge of both the Caliphate podcast and his own show, The Daily, who is his fiance, Lisa Tobin. Nor did it come clean about another person who was really important to that podcast, Andy Mills, allowing him, after some problematic behavior, to be hosting The Daily in Barbero's absence. And they said, this is not the way to be transparent about a problem.
They also, Callie, I believe, called some people in radio and said, please don't report this. You know, we're fixing the problem and go easy on this. And he was protecting his, which is just unheard of for any kind of a reporter to contact another news organization and tell them what do or don't say. All right, Dan, you're next.
Okay, I also have a rave for 80-year-old Diana Wiener. You probably never heard her name, but she's a retiree living in a retirement community in Yonkers, New York, and she was not satisfied with the kind of information that the management was giving residents about COVID-19 cases, people who had been hospitalized or those who had even passed away. And so she decided to start a newsletter. She got someone to proofread what she wrote. She had sources from people who worked within the building to give her information. She printed off 170 glossy newsletters. She called her newsletter The Buzz, and she named names. This was important information, she felt, for example, for when you went to the hospital, went to the doctor's office, and they would ask, who have you been around? Have you been, you know, next door, or have you been in contact with someone who has COVID-19? It was difficult to tell if you weren't getting good information. And guess what? She would slip these under the doors of residents, and they appreciated it so much that they started slipping money under her door, envelopes, anywhere from $5 to $500.
Well,
she has, again, no journalism experience. She used to own a furniture store, I guess.
Yeah, a new way.
If you have good stories to tell and people want that information, they'll pay for it, even if you're 80 years old.
That's great. I love it. All right. Well, on a theme here, I, too, have a rave tonight for someone who did some reporting about COVID, and that's Sarah Seidner from CNN, who was on CNN's Good Day the other day with Allison Camerota. She had just completed a 4.5-minute package about all these hospitals she had just visited, and then she finished the report and then was live on camera. Here's a little bit of what happened.
You know, this is the 10th hospital that I have been. I'm sorry. This is the 10th. I apologize. I'm going to try to get through this. This is the 10th hospital that I have been in. and to see the way that these families have to live after this and the heartache that goes so far and so wide. It's really hard to take. I'm sorry, Allison.
Hey, Sarah, no apology. No apology needed.
You know, it was hard to watch, and it made me squirm a little bit, but it was so real and so genuine. She had seen so much, and she obviously had just listened to her own report in her ear and was reliving all the experience she had had over the last few days, and that was her reaction. And I totally sympathize with her. So that is it. Good work, Sarah Seidner.